trash,
garbage,
rubbish,
waste.
Because of our obsession with consumerism, humans are the only animal that create non-biodegradable waste. Now, with a population of over 7.5 billion, the amount of waste we generate each day is unprecedented. The issue of what to do with our waste is a troubling one. As more and more people consume and then throw away, we are filling the earth with waste as well as polluting our oceans with it. But what if there was an answer to our problem? And what if that answer lay beyond the stratosphere? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer all manner of queries, although I'll let you in on a little secret, the science and the space ones are my favourite. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if we shot our trash into space? Before we get into this video, I want to ask you guys what ways you're working to reduce your waste. I have a pack of reusable straws, and I have a reusable coffee mug, and I do try and keep my water bottle to fill up again in the future rather than buying new ones, but I know that there is still a lot more that I can do. Do let me know your efforts in the comments section down below, and a gold star for each and every one of you. Also, please do like this video and share it with a friend, and stick around to the end where I'll be reading some comments from a previous one. Trash in space. Space junk. Things are going to get messy, but firstly, let me explain why we would even, you know, want to fill space with diapers and plastic bottles and other such junk. At the moment, humans generate around 3.5 million tons of waste every day, but by the end of this century, in 80 years' time, it is estimated that humans will be pumping out 11 million tons of trash a day. Where will it end? The biggest offender is plastic. Invented in 1907, to this day, 9 billion tons of plastic have been produced, but under 10% has ever been recycled, which means that single-use plastics are ending up both in landfill and in our oceans. On land, landfill is causing space issues, plus burying trash causes both air and water pollution, and even the simple act of transporting trash to landfill sites causes pollution in vehicle emissions. That aside, current trends suggest that by 2050, there'll actually be more plastic in the ocean by weight than real marine life. Not only is it killing our marine life by being there, it's also outnumbering it. So as you can see, waste is a problem. So what would happen if we just straight up jettisoned our trash troves? Would that not solve all of our problems? Well, get ready, because the short answer is no. Listen, catapulting our bin bags into the sun seems like absolute lols, but that isn't really how it works. To remove trash from our planet, we would need to do so via the only current available means of removing something from Earth, a rocket. The only thing is, rockets are premium rate expensive, and actually can't really hold that much. Right now, our best available rockets can carry 11 tons of weight at a time. Now, bearing in mind, by the end of the century, we'll be producing a million times that in one day. Like, I mean, are we seriously going to be sending a million rockets a day into space? Because, mate, that is expensive. Launching one rocket right now takes months, if not years, of preparation, and costs circa $100 million. So, what is 100 million times a million? That, whatever that is how much we'd have to spend a day, because, can we really afford to do that every single day by the end of the century? Even now, could we afford to send 333,000 rockets into space a day? No, of course not, you're crazy. The CIA calculates that there is around $80 trillion of broad money in the world right now, and a video on the channel Brightside puts the yearly cost of trash disposal in space at 1.6 quadrillion. So let's just say we absolutely do not have enough money and leave it there. Oh, wait, you don't want to leave it there? You want to pretend that we could just use the cheat code in Sims and just like magic the money here? Well then, Claposius, or Rosebud, or whatever the magic word is these days. You got it. Listen, babe, if you want to jettison your junk, the amount of space needed for all of the rockets to launch would be bigger than the entirety of the United States. So, you know. Also, with a rising population, who has space for this? Where would we even build a trash continent? It just isn't feasible. Also, how would everyone get their trash into one place? Or would there be several trash rocket launch sites across the world? Whatever the setup, it would become the biggest industry and employer in the world too. From the building of a rocket to the launch, can you imagine the people power needed? And would these trash rockets be manned? Because what a job. Some videos out there have asked why we don't dump our trash into the sun, but the answer is, we just can't get it there. Our rockets would simply melt. robots. So sure, an unmanned rocket to the sun we could maybe just point and shoot, but then poof, there goes our rocket. Good job, we have loads of money to build new ones. Oh wait, what? So what about a rocket popping up high enough to take the trash off the Earth, but not so high that it becomes unfeasible, she says, whilst imagining something wholly unfeasible in essence. Well, that would create a big problem. You see, we already do have a small amount of trash in space, and it is causing massive issues. A lot of our old satellites are stuck in space and causing havoc to our new satellites. They're straight up breaking them. Also, the International Space Station could get pretty wrecked, which would be a massive step back for research and could even kill the astronauts up there. Do we want blood on our hands? I do not think so. Some of our junk may float away, and that's the ideal outcome, for us anyway. But a lot of it may fall back down to Earth. While a lot would burn up on re-entry, that would release harmful chemicals, and once again, 11 million tons a day. That's a lot of poisonous gas. Plus, some larger chunks would fall back down to Earth, and then you may literally be killed by flaming plastic, which again would be awful, and again would be more blood on our hands. Okay, so the return to sender issue sounds pretty awful. Can we just dump our trash on the moon? I mean, sure, if we wanted to spend all of our money on something pointless and unsustainable, then yeah. But as we know, the moon has low gravity and no atmosphere. Trash likely would never reach escape velocity and float away, but it would make landing a rocket on the moon pretty hard as time went on. Garbage moon or garbage humans. Also, think about this. Imagine we did invent trash rockets that could get far enough away from Earth to ditch our litter. What would happen then? What if someone or something else finds our litter and isn't happy? How would you feel if your neighbor started dumping their waste on the edge of your property? You'd probably be annoyed, right? And to be honest, I can't blame you. We don't know if there's any life out there right now. Odds are yes, and well, we don't want to be paying the intergalactic fine for littering, do we? Honestly, props not. Look, let me draw you to what Bill Nye had to say.
Earth is a closed system. We cannot leave the Earth. There's no place to go. There's no place to throw your trash.
That's right, the Earth is a closed system. We need to find a way to deal with our problem. Burying it hasn't worked, and neither would spewing it into space-time. Bill Nye's motto is reduce, recycle, reuse, rethink, and he is right. Right now, on average, across the world, people throw away 99% of things that they have bought within the first 6 months of buying it, and that simply isn't acceptable. But Scandinavian countries, notably Sweden, are pioneering the way forward by converting waste into energy. Bill Nye predicts that we will mine trash in the future for useful materials, and some are even experimenting with the idea of using trash as building materials. We could be building skyscrapers out of things that we've thrown away. And again, we can all help by living more sustainably. Now, I did a video on Inform Overload that you should definitely check out. This was about Thai stores using banana leaves as packaging instead of plastic, and that's a good start, right? Once again though, I want to ask you guys what you are doing for the cause. I know that I could be doing more, and I will try and better educate myself. I don't want those aliens coming after me because of my space junk. Before I leave, I just want to read some comments from What If an Asteroid Destroyed the Moon, and then I guess we'd be glad that we didn't fill it with junk and trash, right? Stephen Matthews said, they will have discovered where we're hiding all the cheese. Oh my god, if only. Cheese, oh my god, you made me think about cheese. I'm really hungry. Jeez. Joshua Neal said, ancient civilizations worship the moon. Little fun fact for everyone. That's true. And to be honest, I feel like I worship the moon a little bit. I love that moon. Good Money said, Rebecca just served Eric life's biggest mic drop. Bam. Sorry, Eric. Kevin Apen said, what if we downloaded our minds onto computers? I mean, that sounds like a very, very good question, and perhaps something that we could tackle in the future. So guys, that is all we have time for there. If you like this video, please do leave a thumbs up and share it with a friend. You could even let me know what you think will solve the trash problem. For now though, I'm your host Rebecca Philgate. I will catch you in the next video. But until then, please do stay curious, stay alert, and indeed, never, ever stop questioning.